everyone, I'm Mike Trosel, and we continue our celebration of golf across America with West Virginia, the Mountain State, wild and wonderful. It's where Mother's Day was first celebrated back in 1908. It's also the birthplace of Bill Campbell, the 1964 U.S. Amateur Champion and World Golf Hall of Famer. It's also the home state of the man we have on the line right now, the governor of West Virginia, Jim Justice. Jim, thank you so much for joining us.
No, thank you, Mike. Glad to be here.
Now, Governor, you aren't just the governor of West Virginia, also a big golfer. You played golf and were your captain at Marshall when you played. Can you tell us a little bit about what it was like to be there and what it's like to play golf in West Virginia?
Well, Mike, you know, I love Marshall. I started in Tennessee, played a little golf at Tennessee, transferred to Marshall. My sweetheart was at Marshall and everything, coming to Marshall and everything. Ended up being my wife of 1,000 years, and I was able to be the captain of the Marshall golf team a couple of years, and I really enjoyed the golf there, and it was just fantastic. I didn't play all that great, but I really enjoyed it. It's a great, great, great sport, and it teaches you so many life lessons. It's just, I owe a lot of my life to golf in every way, shape, form, or fashion, and was able to play a lot of places all across the country and played so much with Bill Campbell, it was unbelievable. Bill Campbell beat me on a daily basis just about. I can remember I was playing in a state amateur with him when I think I was 14 years old, and we were coming to the 11th hole, and we were both tied at the same time. You know, we're both even par. And I chipped in on the 11th hole to go one under, and you know, I'll never forget, you know, the little snack bar or whatever there is at the 11th hole before you tee off on the 12th hole. And there was groups backed up there. And I'll never forget how nervous that I was to hit that tee shot on the 12th hole. And I didn't hit it very good, to tell you the truth.
That's a great story. And your golf career, you know, you played at Marshall, played in a lot of amateur events, but it goes back even to high school. Were you in the same golf team as Slugger White, rules official on the PGA Tour? And it sounds like you had some good times with Slugger as well.
Well, I did. I mean, Slugger is a great, great, great man. And, you know, we played all through, you know, probably junior high and high school together. We probably, you know, there's days we played 45 holes. We carried our bags. We played every day. And we practiced all together and everything else. We had an incredible golf team, and that's all there is to it. But I can remember just this, and Slugger, forgive me for doing this, but you know, we've carried our bags for 45 holes one day. We've been playing all day. And we're in a real hilly course and everything. And we're coming up the very last hole. And probably about midday, I put a rock in the bottom of his golf bag. You know, Slugger was so strong, it was unbelievable. But that rock probably weighed 3 or 4 pounds, but he carried it all day. And I, you know, it was coming up the last hole and everything. I yelled, "Hey, Slugger, why don't you get that rock out of your bag?" And he turned the bag upside down. Then he proceeded to chase me all over the place. He'd have probably killed me if he could have caught me. But nevertheless, we had a lot of great times together.
Boy, that is certainly a handicap that you gave him for playing those 45 holes. That's pretty incredible. Now, Governor, you've played golf all over the country, all over the world. What makes playing golf in West Virginia unique compared to anywhere else?
Well, West Virginia has 4 of the most incredible seasons in the world. You know, if you were to play golf in the fall in West Virginia, you would have the incredible grandeur that just is all over our state, with the leaves changing colors and the great temperatures. And the springtime, you know, the flowers are just starting to come out and all that kind of stuff. The summers are not brutal. They're not hot. You know, most of the days are in the mid-70s and everything. It's just a paradise. We have valley floor courses. We have mountain courses that have incredible views. But you're surrounded by the beauty of West Virginia and the good people of West Virginia. That's the treasure of West Virginia that people just don't get. But West Virginians are just so appreciative and so loving people and everything. If you haven't played in West Virginia, you need to come to West Virginia.
Well, and the PGA Tour goes to West Virginia every year, the Greenbrier Classic at the Greenbrier, where your family owns the course. What can you tell us about what your family has done there, especially working with the military over the past several years?
Well, we changed the name to a tribute to the military at the Greenbrier, And you know, we have a real, an incredible population. I think 10% of the population of West Virginia are veterans. You know, we just have a Veterans Visibility Day going on today in the Capitol. And so a real life commitment to the military, and we should all be beholden to the military in every way. The tournament in itself, you know, the Old White course, the Metis course, and a bunch of, you know, the Sam Snead course and on, were pretty much completely destroyed in 2016. And so we had to rebuild them and everything, but they're pristine and they're just absolutely just welcoming. And you would absolutely love it to come here and play. We have a great tournament, and you know, we just could never be, you know, more appreciative to all that are participating in the tournament.
Well, Governor, thank you so much for the time. We appreciate it. And for those playing golf with Governor Justice, check the bottom of your golf bag. Make sure there are no rocks in there. Governor Jim Justice helping us celebrate golf in America by highlighting West Virginia.